Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to discuss about introduction to apps, objects, tabs, fields and records. Before starting, let me share you how you can search me on YouTube. You can type my name. So on my channel, you can watch various Salesforce related videos. Now we are going to discuss about apps, objects, tabs, fields and records. So first I'm going to discuss about apps. So an app is a container for all the objects, tabs, and other functionality in Salesforce. Second point says it is similar to a programming project where we keep all our code files. Third point says in Salesforce, app consists simply of a name, a logo, and an ordered set of tabs. So this is how you can see apps in Salesforce. So there will be a menu, from there you can select a particular app. So this picture is related to Salesforce Classic. In Salesforce Lightning, we have app launcher from where we can pick a particular app. Then next thing is objects. So an object is a very similar to a database table in the force.com platform. So remember that in Salesforce, object is similar to a database table. Then second point says the platform comes with a number of standard objects like account, contact, case, lead, and opportunity, etc. So these are some sample names. Beyond these names, some standard objects are also available. Those comes by default with Salesforce platform. The standard object support default apps like Salesforce Sales and Salesforce Service. So these are two default apps. Other than these two, some more default apps are also available. Last point says we can create custom objects in Salesforce as per requirement of the project. So beyond standard object, we can also create custom objects in Salesforce as per the business requirement. So this is the example of database table. So here we have four entities. So this executive assistant, associate degree, human resource, 60,000, 40,000. This complete row is known as record in Salesforce. Then individual column like education requirement, this will be treated as field. So in this table, we can see five fields: position title, education requirements, functional area, max pay, min pay. These five are fields. Then 140,000, this individual is a data value. And then this table, this complete table is known as object in Salesforce. So this way you can understand what is object, what is record, and what is field. So this is the picture of custom object list page. So whenever you create custom objects, this way that object will be visible, you can click on this label so that you can view the information and you can edit and delete also. So if you will watch demonstration how we can create custom objects, then you will get to know about this slide. So this video just contains theoretical information. If you follow upcoming videos in this playlist, then you will see how we can create objects, fields in Salesforce. So this is the detail page of the object. So if you click on this position, then this page will be opened. So here you can see various details related to object and then standard and custom fields information. So again, this picture is related to Salesforce Classic. So my Salesforce Lightning videos are in other playlists, so you can watch that playlist if you want to know about Salesforce Lightning experience. So this picture is related to Salesforce Classic, which is showing object detail page. Then comparison between standard versus custom object. So we are comparing them on the basis of three things: label, plural label, and API name. So if we talk about standard objects, so name will be account, suppose, plural label will be accounts, and API name will be account. For custom, label is student, plural label is students, and API name is student underscore underscore C. So this is the difference by which you can identify like object is standard or custom. So for standard objects, we have only name for API, but for custom, we append underscore underscore C also. So you can read this note as well. Plural label is used for tabs and API name is used in any of the feature like workflow apex, etc. So tabs and API name both are useful. Now we are talking about tabs. So clicking on tab, we can navigate around an app. So if you want to switch between different objects, then you can choose tabs. So every tab serves as the starting point for viewing, editing, and entering information for a specific object. So tab is directly related to an object. When we click a tab, the corresponding homepage that object appears. For example, if we click the accounts tab, homepage appears. It gives you access to all of the account records. We can view detail of a particular record by clicking on it, right? So you can have tabs. Then if you click on tab, then object detail page will be opened. And from there, you can select a particular record which you want to view. So this way you can understand about tab. So home positions, these are two tabs. So again, this picture is related to Salesforce Classic. So if we click on position, so position object details will be available. So here it is showing no recent records are available. So if you click on this new button, so you can fill up the information and records will be created. And if you have existing records, so they will be displayed here. Now we need to talk about fields. So a field is like a database column. There are various data types are available in Salesforce to create fields. By entering values in fields, we create a record in Salesforce. So these are some data types. By using these data types, you can create fields. So auto number, formula, rollup summary, lookup relationship, master detail relationship, external lookup relationship, checkbox, currency, date time, email, geolocation, number, percent, phone, pick list, multi-select, text area long, text area rich, text encrypted, time, URL. So these all are available data types for creating fields. So this is a screenshot to understand how fields look like. So all these are fields like position, title, status, style, functional area, etc. And in these boxes, their data type is also mentioned. So for position title, it is of text field. For status, we are using pick list field. For travel required, we are using checkbox field. For max pay, we are using currency field. So this way, this box is showing which data type we are using to create a field. So you need to know the data type. Without knowing proper or appropriate data type, you cannot create valid fields. Then comes records. So records are the rows or entries in object which are uniquely identified by their IDs. We can create records by entering values in fields available in an object. We can create, edit, view, and delete a record in Salesforce. So this is how you can create a new record. So you need to click on new button. So this form will be available. You can fill this and click on save so that a record will be created. So here you can see various fields are available. So collection of fields create a record and collection of record create a object. And to view or to navigate around object, we create tabs and collection of all the objects and functionality is known as app. This is record view, record list view. So it is showing all existing records. Then this is record detail page. So after creation of record, if you open it, so it will look like this. You can click on edit or delete buttons so that you can do required functionality. So this way we discussed about apps, objects, tabs, fields, and records in this video. If you want to watch these things with the help of demonstrations, so you can follow this playlist. In upcoming videos, you will get to know how we can create these things in Salesforce Classic. For Salesforce Lightning related videos, you can follow other playlists. So I hope you understood whatever I discussed in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce related videos, you can search me on YouTube by my name. So keep following my videos so that you can learn programming. Thank you for watching this video.